This is Congressman Sam B. Hall, Jr., reporting to you from Washington. Just recently, I joined a number of my congressional colleagues for a series of high-level discussions with West German government officials, as well as business and labor leaders in that nation. The discussions were part of an exchange program sponsored and financed by the Heritage Foundation, a private think tank organization with headquarters in Washington, D.C. High on my personal agenda for a serious give and take with our Western German allies was the matter of steel imports. West Germany, like our other trading partners, subsidizes its steel industry. The result has been a virtual flood of steel products on America's shores, which has cost untold jobs in our domestic steel industry, including Lone Star Steel right here in our backyard. As I explained to the West Germans, the only way to stop the international trade wars and so-called protectionist sentiments in international trade is to practice fair trade. One thing that struck me throughout our discussions is that America is not alone in battling recession. Western Europe is undergoing a recession of its own, and the consequences of this recession are very, very serious. There is rising unemployment and higher government deficits throughout Western Europe. European voters seem to be telling their governments to trim social welfare spending, which they blame for high inflation and huge deficits. The Soviet military threat to Western Europe has always occupied a primary, if not the primary, attention of Western Europe. But the current recession apparently now has equal billing. A key indicator of recession is foreign debt and the impact of the debt owed by third world countries to the West. A major reason why President Reagan decided on a Latin American tour is to discuss mounting foreign debt owed by countries like Brazil. Brazil's foreign debt is a staggering $85 billion. I think the Europeans are beginning to learn what some of us in the Congress have been preaching for years, and that is the folly of dumping billions of dollars in foreign aid to countries who totally mismanage their affairs. In my judgment, foreign aid and recession go hand in glove. Unrestricted foreign aid by the United States and its Western allies has created virtual chaos and threatens bankruptcies on a major scale. For instance, some $28 billion is owed right now by bankrupt Poland, and most of this is owed to the Western countries. Incredibly, the United States and our allies have on the books no less than $80 billion in outstanding loans to Soviet Russia and its satellites. Cuba, for instance, owes the West $12 billion. Will it ever be paid? I wouldn't count on it. What makes us all mad is the fact that the countries with all this bad debt are the ones who criticize the United States and the West at every turn. But when the crunch comes, they look to us for help, and it gets plenty tiresome. It may seem naive, but if the non-aligned and communist-dominated nations of the world would stop preaching government control over every phase of human endeavor and start promoting some old-fashioned free enterprise, they might, just might, wipe out some of this debt. One thing for sure, the more the debt, the more we face recession. I get the feeling that government officials throughout Western Europe are accepting this fact of economic life. European taxpayers, like American taxpayers, are getting fed up. I only hope their respective governments get the word on time. This is Congressman Sam B. Hall, Jr., reporting to you from Washington. Thank you for listening.